We're talking practical here. How do you keep the devil out of your house? Shut up. Okay. Right? Because the devil so many times comes right out through that tongue. Are you with me? And so the devil wants to create a problem in your home. You're agitated about something and you speak before you think, okay? You put your mouth in gear before your mind is activated, okay? And so your mouth is running and saying all kinds of things, and before long you've said destructive words, and now you've got something to add on top of what's already been frustrating you. You've got a problem that's now exacerbated from what it was before. You've thrown fuel on the fire, if you will, and your words have created a problem for you. Let me remind you today that you can control your tongue. The tongue is not an independent force. It just wags without your cooperation. Okay? If you don't feel like you can control your tongue, I will promise you this is a better solution than just letting it wag. Go to the hardware store and buy a big roll of duct tape. It works well, okay? Just slap it across your face whenever you need. When you cannot seemingly control what you're about to say, say, excuse me for a moment, okay? And you walk around, you grab your big old strip of duct tape and slap it right across between your ears at the lower part of your face, and I promise you it'll be hard to say anything destructive with all that sticky stuff on your mouth, okay? But it's worth it to do. So what I'm saying, this is so important because the devil walks into your house through your words. Are you with me today? Okay. And so you have to ban destructive words. I'm not going to speak those words. I refuse to say that. Now you can't make somebody else change their words, but you can change yours. The Bible says a gentle answer turns away wrath, Proverbs 15, verse 1. You can, even when they are wrathful toward you, you don't have to be wrathful in return, okay? You choose your behavior.